What's up, everybody? It's Jerry, and today I'll be defending Batman Forever. Batman Forever is the greatest Batman movie ever. Seriously, though, it is, at least, the prettiest. Cinematographer Steven Goldblatt got an Oscar nomination for his work on this movie. Couple that with Barbara Ling's amazing production design, and you have a movie that's hard to look away from. Though the film takes place in Tim Burton's universe, it definitely feels like its own thing. Director Joel Schumacher was tasked with making a more family-friendly Batman after Burton's insanely dark Batman Returns, and that's not a bad thing. Schumacher was able to make this his own, with the colorful cinematography, slick costumes and sets, and a zany tone that all put a smile on my face when I was 13. The new cast is also pretty memorable. I'm not a big fan of Val Kilmer, but his take on Batman and his alter ego Bruce Wayne is not bad. I also really enjoyed Tommy Lee Jones and Jim Carrey as Two-Face and the Riddler, respectively. They have great chemistry, which is surprising considering the two didn't get along during production. And holy hell, look at this Batmobile. This thing is slick as hell, and is hands down my favorite Batmobile. Lastly is the fantastic music by Elliot Goldenthal. He had big shoes to fill when he took over scoring duties from Danny Elfman. We all know Elfman's iconic theme, but Goldenthal managed to compose a very heroic and memorable fanfare that stuck with me long after the movie was over. Say what you will about the film, but you can't say it didn't try. It's a gorgeous movie and a great entry in the Batman series. That's why I give it an A-.